We have been invited by HD and Kaleigh to share in the joy of this day as they create their own home and start their own family. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
You may be seated. Home is the oldest institution known to man, created by, designed by God Himself. And He gives many reasons for the institution called the home. And you and I are participating with HD and Kaleigh in the formation of their very own home and family. Very long time ago, God created Adam, placed him in a beautiful setting, a garden called Eden, and provided everything that Adam needed save one thing. As Adam gave names to all the animals, Adam was both alone and lonely. God saw Adam's predicament and did not want Adam to be either of those things, either alone or lonely. So He caused a deep sleep to come on Adam, and while Adam slept, He took a rib from Adam's side, and with this rib He fashioned a woman. And when He brought her to Adam, these are Adam's words on that day: "This is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken from man's side." I want you to notice where that bone came from. Not from his head to rule over him, not from his foot to be trampled on by him, but from his side to be his companion, to be his partner, to go with him, walk with him, support and encourage him, and he for her. Adam continued, "So now shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." That's exactly what is taking place here today. At least two occasions after this, Jesus himself emphasized and gave his approval to God's arrangement. And one of them was at a marriage feast, just like this one. He approved of what God did, what God's design was, and its intention. The Song of Solomon, written by a husband to his wife, says that this institution of marriage, the relationship between husband and wife, is the most intimate of all relationships on the face of this earth. So here's what I want you guys to do. It is my prayer that your marriage is characterized by love and filled with sweetness and tenderness and all of those things that you both deserve. To help us with that, I want to read from 1 Corinthians what Paul wrote about this concept and the quality of love that is demanded of us. "Love suffers long, is kind. Love does not envy, is not puffed up. Love does not behave itself unseemly, does not seek its own, is not easily provoked, thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails." It is my prayer for you that as you start your family today, your own home, that your marriage, your family, your home is characterized by this type of love that does not seek its own, is not easily provoked, thinks no evil, always places God as its highest priority, and that you guys make Jesus Christ the hub of your marriage. I promise if you do, then your lives together will be good. Here's what I want you to do for me. I want you to remember the very first time you met, when you met, how you met, and I want you to take this journey with me from that first meeting to this point today, where you are pledging your faith and love to each other and for each other. And while you think about those things and continue to hold hands, I want to read something to you. It's called I Cherish You. It has become one of my favorites of all the things I have ever read. I cherish you. You are the sweet scent that drifts upon the air I breathe. You are the music of my life. You are the nourishment of my soul. You are my reason for living. It is with you that I experience the wonders of the world. It is with you that I triumph over the challenges in my path. It is your partnership that will lead me to the fulfillment of my dreams. It is your friendship that guides me as I grow and learn. It is your patience and wisdom that calm my restless nature. It is through you that I know my true self. I do not take you for granted. I cherish you. I choose you. I choose you today in the presence of people who love us. I choose you tomorrow in the privacy of our hearts. I choose you in strength and weakness. I choose you in health and sickness. I choose you in joy and sorrow. I will choose you over all others every day for all the days of my life. Kaleigh and HD have agreed to, consented together. They want to speak to each other, and we're going to give them the opportunity to do that right now as they pledge both faith and love to one another and vow to be with one another until they are separated by death.
To you I promise to give my life. To you I promise to give my love. To you I promise to give my happiness. To you I promise to give my sadness. To you I promise to give my everything, because you are everything to me. You are the woman of my dreams. You are the answer of my prayers and the love of my life. I can't imagine the amazing moments ahead of us, but equally as important, I can't imagine getting through the hard times to come with anyone but you. I promise to love you with everything I have, my sweet, beautiful Kaleigh.
Gosh.
Yeah.
You're gone first.
I don't know how I'm gonna follow that. But we'll see.
I vow to love you fiercely with every ounce of my being. I promise to be alongside you to help you get back up every time you fall, to support you through every choice, trial, and victory. Before you came into my life, everything seemed so black and white, but that's all changed now. Since the first day that I met you, I see everything with clarity and color. I'm so unbelievably excited to get up every morning to talk to you, see you, and to make you laugh. And the fact that I get to do all of those things with you for the rest of my life makes me even more excited. I know that no matter what obstacles or joys life brings our way, my place will always be next to you.
It is always, always an extra privilege and honor to be able to participate in an event like this when I have had the pleasure of watching through a lifetime of watching you as a girl grow into a very beautiful young woman, and to learn the man you're marrying and his character and his ability, and to see how much he loves you, is especially, it's an especially good privilege and honor for me to be able to participate in that with you. I want to ask you guys some questions, and they're simple, and the answer to them is very easy, especially based on what you have just said to one another. HD, do you take Kaleigh to be your wife, promising before God with your family and friends as witness that you will be to her a loving, devoted, faithful husband, that you will provide for her and protect her, that you will honor and love her, remain with her in sickness and in health, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaking all others, keep yourself to her and to her only for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kaleigh. Do you take HD to be your husband? Promise. Wait until I finish. Promising before God with your family and friends as witnesses that you will be to him a faithful, loving, and devoted wife, that you will honor and love him, remain with him in sickness and in health, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaking all others, keep yourself to him and to him only for as long as you both shall live? Very good. Are there rings? Are there rings?
Yes.
Good job, Parker. HD, take Kaleigh's ring, place it on the ring finger of her left hand, and repeat after me. Hold it in place. I, HD. Take thee, Kaleigh.
Take thee, Kaleigh.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Okay. Take HD's ring. And put it on the ring finger of his left hand. And repeat after me. You can spit on it. I, Kaleigh, take thee, HD, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Kaleigh, take your bouquet back. And that's a big one, so I might have had you get it back too soon. Inasmuch, and this is my favorite part, inasmuch as HD and Kaleigh have consented together, pledged their faith and love to each other, have witnessed these vows before God and this company, and have sealed the same by the giving and receiving of rings, I therefore, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Christ and the state of Arkansas, pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Get a room. Is there more?
Here's what I want you guys to do. I want you to turn and face them away from me.
Okay.
Even though you're not looking at me, listen to the words that I am saying.
Okay.
HD, may you guard well the future of this woman who has committed to you her all. Kaleigh has paid you the highest compliment within her power to pay. She has left her parents and given up her very name for you, the man she loves. May you ever be true to that confidence and trust she has placed in you. May you love her as Christ loved the church, with a self-giving, sacrificial love. Kaleigh, May you ever strive in life to keep by your virtues this heart you have won by your graces. May you be true to your marriage vows and to HD, who has paid you the highest compliment within his power to pay, to make you the queen of his home and of his heart. He has endowed you with his honor and love. Guys, let's pray. Father in heaven, we are so grateful that you are a good God and that you are a good Father, and you give to us good and perfect gifts. Father, in your wisdom, you have given to us homes, families, husbands, wives, parents, children, grandparents, grandchildren, all of those attachments that you knew that we needed so badly and that help us, that encourage us, that support us. Father, we are grateful for HD and for Kaleigh, for the creation of their home, and we pray that as they live on this side of time, that they make you their highest priority, that they agree together to serve you all the days of their lives, that they walk in the light of your word, and that they continue to trust you as long as they are here. Father, we ask your blessing on this home, that you would comfort them, be with them, be near them. Father, we are grateful for the gift of Jesus Christ, your Son, the salvation that is in him, the hope that we have by his blood, and our obedience to the commands of the gospel. We pray your blessings on this event and on this home, and it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. It is my pleasure, honor, and privilege to present to you, for the very first time anywhere, Mr. and Mrs. Howard Dean Bobo. That was, you can't do that. That's what I said. So, you're done. You're finished. This concludes the service. They're going to stand in receiving line. A reception has been prepared for you. When you are dismissed, then you are free to walk through, talk to them, hug them, visit with them for a little while, and then keep walking. Go over to the reception area. They have some more pictures that need to be taken, and as soon as those are completed, they will join you at the reception. Before you go, though, thank you so much for coming, for being here, for participating in this with them. I know they love you very much and that you love them. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. So thank you. You are dismissed.